This is a PMS-7002 laser dust sensor from Plan Tower. I've had it for about 2 years now and it's been running continuously, and I've collected a fair bit of data as you can see here. In particular, you can really see the fires we had recently at the start of 2020. Although, on average, over the past 2 years, it's been exposed to an average of 6.4 micrograms per cubic meter of dust at PM2.5 size. So it hasn't been in the most demanding scenario, although just looking at it, it's pretty dirty. So I thought we'd take a look inside, clean it, and show you how it works. Firstly, I'm just going to peel off this plastic protection that's on the metalwork. The metal cover on both sides are held down by these little clips at either edge, and you can just get a spudger and insert them between the two and pry up and bend the metalwork, and it comes apart pretty easy. However, I do find that this style of spudger that's thinner at the end is much easier to get between the two pieces and pry them apart. And once you've got the metal over all of those clips, it's just a case of pulling on it until it opens up. Although, you gotta be careful and make sure you don't pull too hard, otherwise you'll damage the plastic or bend the metal too much. Okay, already this is pretty interesting just with one side off, although whilst we're at it we'll take the second side off, which is now much easier now that you don't have to get the spudger between the two pieces just coming from the side like this. Now we have both sides off, we can take a look inside. And the first thing we notice is this metalwork, the case. On the back of it is this black sticker, and that would be to prevent light reflections either from the laser or from outside light getting onto the sensor and affecting the readings. And we can see inside this thing there's a nice little centrifugal fan, a laser, and this little optical cavity. And we can also see that there's some springs clearly to keep the chassis of the device grounded, and I'm going to remove them before I lose them. The other side of the device has the PCB, and this is actually different to what I was expecting. I took one of these apart last year, and it was a completely different design. Here's a picture, and as you can see, this one today, it has a custom Plan Tower chip, whereas the other one has a ST chip and some other 8-pin SOP package. So I'm not quite sure what's going on here. Is this other one a counterfeit or something? Now, the reason why I took this other one apart last year was because I was a little bit dumb and managed to plug it in the wrong way around, and yeah, it doesn't like 5 volts with the wrong polarity. Turns out I blew something up. However, looking at the thermal image of it, it was pretty easy to figure out what chip was getting way too hot. And it ended up just being this little 5-pin SOT23 device here, which I assumed was probably a regulator, so I replaced it with one of these Micrel 5504 regulators I had laying around, and it's been working ever since. Now, if you're like me, you're probably wondering how on earth this thing actually works and how it derives a value of micrograms per cubic meter. Well, it's actually very similar to how a smoke detector works. However, unlike a smoke detector or cheaper dust sensor, this thing actually has to distinguish the difference between a small dust particle and a large dust particle. And to do that, we have this whole package here. This is the block diagram that the manufacturer gives us, so we're going to look at how this light scattering actually works. Unlike a smoke detector that usually uses an infrared LED, this device has a surprisingly red laser, and it shines through here, it shines through these two light baffles, and then into this light trap at the end, and that's just to stop any stray reflections from hitting the photodiode at the bottom here. We also know from the datasheet that this device has a controlled flow rate of 0.1 liters per minute, and that comes out here across the sensing region and then out through here through the centrifugal fan. And that means we have a steady stream of air with suspended dust particles coming through here. And as a dust particle crosses this laser beam, it will scatter the light onto this photodiode, and you can then pick that up and count exactly how many dust particles have crossed that laser beam, and then you can infer through the 0.1 liters per minute exactly how many dust particles are in 1 cubic meter of air. And of course, the amount of light scattered by the dust particle is proportional to the size of the dust particle as well as its reflectance. I suspect this is the method that this unit uses in order to determine the particle sizes that we see in the data output. However, some other more expensive scientific dust measuring devices can also measure how long the dust particle spends in the laser beam, and at a constant flow rate you can then infer the size of the dust particle. However, that's a lot more difficult to measure, so I doubt this unit's doing that. So taking a look at the PCB now, and we can see after the connector, there's a surprising amount of passives actually, but there's two SOT23 5-pin packages. We know one of them is going to be a 3.3 volt regulator for the integrated circuits and powering the laser and everything. The other one, I'm not quite sure what it does. It's probably got something to do with that fan. Might be some sort of PWM controller, because the microcontroller is able to regulate the fan speed in order to get that 0.1 liters per minute. Next, we also have here a surprising amount of passives. I'm really not quite sure what they're doing with all of these passives, and honestly I couldn't be bothered to reverse engineer this thing, especially with the black PCB, although that is kind of required to minimize light reflections. Considering it's under the photodiode, it's got something to do with that. Next we have this rather large QFN package that's been custom labeled Plan Tower. I doubt this is actual custom silicon, as that would be pretty expensive for something like this that requires a reasonable amount of processing power. However, my wizard senses are tingling and telling me, by the way the package is shaped with that location dimple and the way the leads are formed, this is probably an STM32F part, I would bet. But it could be anything, it could be some Chinese MCU manufacturer I've never heard of. Over here we have some more passives, as well as what looks like a 3-pin SOT23 transistor. This is clearly to drive the laser. The actual constant current part of the laser driving, though, is on the back of the PCB next to the TO3 laser. And up here, interestingly enough, we actually have a unpopulated device. It looks like the footprint for an 8-pin DFN with an exposed pad. My best guess for what this would be is probably some sort of memory option. Maybe it's some sort of E2 PROM that allows it to record locally some historic data. Also, here we have 4 holes through the PCB so that air can flow to the other side. I'm not quite sure why they've gone with 4 holes and not a slot. I suspect it's probably got something to do with either a limitation with their PCB design package, or maybe they're trying to reduce the wear on the drill bit drilling a slot. Now, the PCB is held down by these screws here, but the other side is nothing, it's just traces. Now, I opened this device up to primarily clean it, so having a look at it now, it looks like there's a fair amount of dust. There's quite a fair bit on the blades of this fan. There's a little bit around here, and it looks like there might actually be a little bit on the actual photodiode. Now, this is why they're so particular about how you orient this device when you deploy it, because if you deploy it the wrong way around, the dust can actually settle on the photodiode. So this has been in the position in which the photodiode has been facing downwards so that no dust can collect on it, hence why it's so clean. On the other side, on the PCB, we can see that it's collected a fair amount of dust as well. I'm not quite sure why they actually have air flowing over the PCB. To me it seems like a big risk for contamination, although I suspect it allows them to manufacture it a lot cheaper than having to put the PCB in a separate compartment. Now, I'm just cleaning this with a normal art brush, because I don't particularly want to get my nice ESD brushes all dirty with dust, but I'm not too worried about this. This fan here isn't actually held in with any screws, it's just a press fit, so you can just push it out and clean it separately. And there's actually quite a lot of dust in this fan. I think there's probably more dust in the fan than anything else, which I suppose is kind of expected. And I wonder if this has actually got anything to do with the design of the PMS-A003, which actually has the fan on the outside of the device, and it's held in with two screws and some clips. So I wonder if that has anything to do with making it easier to clean. Although, one thing to note is the plastic on this fan isn't as strong as the metal, and I've actually managed to damage one in the past, so that's one thing to be careful of. And I'm just going to clean the rest of the device here with that same art brush. Although, in order to clean that photodiode, I'm using a Q-tip soaked in 100% isopropanol alcohol. And with that done, we can have a look around, and everything looks much cleaner now. I don't know if this will have any effect on the performance, but it's good to just know it's not horrifically dirty inside now. And reassembly is easy enough, it's just a matter of popping the fan back in, putting the connectors back on, and in order to put these metal shields back on, you can just bend the sides back in, although making sure not to bend them too far, and then just pushing them back on, they clip into place. I'm not sure how many times you can do this before the metal starts to fatigue, but I imagine if you're doing this every like 2 years, it's not going to be a problem. And so that's what's inside one of these and how to clean it. So thanks for watching.